And again, one of the television correspondents at this news conference, in which the president is there on an unannounced visit, part of a ceremonial signing of the agreement, and you see it there, one right after the other. One of the journalists jumps up, throwing the shoes at the president. Let's listen in. And we have been looking at video that just arrived here a few moments ago. Video of a news conference with President Bush and Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki as they talked about their signing of this agreement, the Status of Forces Agreement and Strategic Agreement. Let's listen in to the reaction. Amazing. You see one of the journalists there. We are getting reports that he is from al-Baghdadia television. A correspondent at this press conference reportedly says, "This is the end." Makes the statement, "This is the end," just before throwing the shoes. Patty Colhane joins us now live from the White House. Patty?
Hey, Christina, how are you? As you've just seen the video, President Bush, we should point out, was not injured. As you saw, the shoe sailed over his head. And I'm just going to ask if we could switch the monitor real quick so I can see what you're seeing. We do know that Dana Perino, though, has a bit of a black eye. Apparently, she was caught in the melee to get a hold of this television reporter and got a microphone in her eye. So Dana Perino, the White House spokeswoman, has a bit of a black eye. You're seeing the video here. Apparently, as you said, this is a television reporter, and he screamed out, "This is a farewell kiss, you dog." Now, people at home might be wondering, what is the importance of the shoe? Well, in an Arab culture, that is considered, the sole of the shoe is considered an insult. So it was this reporter's way of insulting President Bush during his surprise visit to Baghdad.
Yeah. So what if the guy threw a shoe at me? No, I consider it an important step in on the road toward an Iraq that can sustain itself, govern itself, and defend itself. But let me talk about the guy throwing the shoe. It is one way to gain attention. It's like going to a political rally and having people yell at you. It's like driving down the street and have people not gesturing with all five fingers. It's a way for people to draw, you know, attention. I don't know what the guy's cause is, but one thing is for certain, he caused you to ask me a question about him. I didn't feel the least bit threatened by it. These journalists here were very apologetic. They were, you know, they were, you know, said this doesn't represent the Iraqi people, but that's what happens in free societies where people try to draw attention to themselves. And so I guess he was effective because he caused you to say something about it. Now, in terms of the agreements, this is a major achievement. Is it the end? Absolutely not. There's more work to be done. And all this basically says is we made good progress, and we'll continue to work together to achieve peace. That's what we want. Freedom and peace. And so now I'm honored to be back here. It's my fourth visit to Iraq, and as a sitting president, and I have been looking forward to this visit. It's very kind of you, Mr. Prime Minister, to have invited me.
I take two. Okay.